Greetings, everyone, and welcome. I'm the Chancellor of Soul, Mike Boone. You've tuned in to another edition of Soul Facts, a show highlighting the history and music of legendary artists and preserving their legacy. In this edition features an artist who helped blueprint the development of the early soul sounds of New Orleans, riding high in the crest of the 1960s. Soul Facts Spotlight artist, Mr. Lee Dorsey. Irving Lee Dorsey was born in New Orleans, Louisiana, in the Ninth Ward section. Music historians document in black and white his birth dates being either 1924, 1926, or 1927 on December 4th. At 10 years of age, Lee's father moved the family to Portland, Oregon for better employment. Lee's music influence was listening to hillbilly music, later adapting his singing style from country singers. Years later, Dorsey was drafted into the U.S. Navy during World War II and served on a destroyer. His ship was attacked by a Japanese AGM Zero plane where he injured his leg. After 4 years of military service, Lee pursued a career as an undefeated feather lightweight prize fighter weighing at 130 pounds, billed as Kid Chocolate. Dorsey gave up boxing in 1955 and moved back to New Orleans. There under the GI Bill, he studied automation repair. He secured a job at Rich's Auto Shop owned by a local DJ named Ernie the Whip as a welder in 1957. Lee loved working around the shop along with his love for singing. One day a talent scout named Renald Richard, who was a former jazz trumpeter and band leader for Ray Charles, and who also co-wrote Ray's 1954 hit, I Got a Woman, uncredited, had taken his car there to be fixed. While repairing the car, Dorsey started to sing, leaving an impression on Richard. Renard invited Lee to come down to Cosimo Matassa's recording studio, J&M, that same evening. Lee recorded his first tune he and Renard Richard composed together, called Rock, issued on Matassa's Rex label in 1959, along with a young singer-songwriter, Alan Toussaint, featured on piano. I said, rock for the baby. Rock, baby. Yeah, rock for the baby. Rock, baby. Go ahead, rock for the baby. And rock some. Dorsey and Toussaint would begin a mutual music relationship in the near future. His next release, Lover of Love, written by Alan Toussaint, back with Lottie Moe, the popular side, was released on Joe Banaschek's Valiant label in January of 1961. But it was picked up by ABC Paramount in March for national distribution. Oh, Lottie Moe. Oh, Lottie Moe. Oh, Lottie, Lottie Moe. Oh, Lottie Moe. Both Rock and Lottie Moe failed the chart. Lee, unfortunately under contract, was forced to relinquish all of his royalties to Renald Richard. So he went back to working at the auto shop until his contract with Richard expired. Years later, Lee Dorsey remade Lottie Moe in 1968. In 1961, a representative from Bobby Robinson's Fire Fury label named Marshall Seahorn came to New Orleans on a promotions trip. While down there, he heard a record that sounded like Ray Charles, but found out it was Lee Dorsey's song Lottie Moe on the radio. Seahorn then flew to New York and brought the Dorsey song back to Bobby Robinson and played it for him. Robinson loved the song and called down to New Orleans and found out that Lee was not obligated to any record label. You see, by this time, his contract with Renald Richards was terminated. Bobby Robinson flew down to New Orleans and went to Dorsey's farmhouse with swings on a porch. In discussion, Robinson asked Lee if he had written any songs. Dorsey said no. While chatting, some kids on the porch swing started singing a nursery chant, "Sitting on a la la, yeah, yeah." Bobby liked it and asked the kids to sing it again, but they were too bashful and they started giggling. Afterwards, Lee and Robinson went to a dive called a Miller Bar to discuss about providing material to record. Bobby couldn't get the kid's song off his mind and asked the waitress to give him a pad and a pencil. He started to write lyrics to the kid's monosyllabic song. To Bobby and Lee's terms, Yaya meant girlfriend, so the artist is waiting and worried that she won't show up in his anticipation, which became the storyline. The song was composed in 15 minutes. Done in the style of New Orleans, the piano arrangement was by Alan Toussaint, who couldn't participate in the recording because he was under contract with Minute Records. So he recorded the 88 piece on tape and gave it to Bobby Robinson, where Robinson had a session player replicated on the record. Yaya charted number one on November 6, 1961 for 1 week only.
Sitting in la la waiting for my yaya. Sitting in la la waiting for my yaya.
Around the time when Yaya was released, the increasing sales and popularity of the song led Dorsey to an invitation to appear on Dick Clark's American Bandstand in late summer of 1961. Now, there was a rumor that spread it that Lee Dorsey became too big for his britches and hugged Dick Clark's wife on national television for the nation to see. With segregation in tow, seeing black and white people intertwined with each other was considered a taboo in the eyes of Southern audiences and sponsors. So Dorsey would not appear on Bandstand for the next few years, as the rumor went. You know, speaking of songwriting acknowledgments, the sheet music of Yaya credits Clarence Lewis and Morris Levy, founder of Roulette Records, whose participation in co-composing the song has been in question, but Lee Dorsey and Bobby Robinson are uncredited on the sheet music. Go figure. Well, anyway, Yaya has been covered 14 times by various artists, including John Lennon, who with his son Julian on drums, played a snippet of the song featured on his 1974 classic LP, Walls and Bridges, and also in his 1975 album of Rock and Roll, where Lennon records the song in its entirety. Lee Dorsey's next release, Do Re Mi, was a clone to his hit Yaya, using the same chord progressions and the tone scale as a title song, metaphorically.
Do Re Mi Fa Sol La Ti. My uncle there was a passing.
The song hit number 22 R&B on February 17, 1962, and was composed by guitarist Earl King and arranged by the great Alan Toussaint. The Fury imprint released its self-titled album, Yaya, but it didn't gain any sales nor receive any chart action whatsoever. Well, no support and promotion after three single releases failed to chart, Lee soon afterwards departed with Fury and Bobby Robinson. In 1963, Lee Dorsey's association with Alan Toussaint was cut short because Toussaint was suddenly drafted into the military. During this time, Lee recorded three uncharted singles on two labels, Hello Good Looking on Smash in 1963, Organ Grind and Swing, and You're Breaking Me Up, both on Constellation Records of Chicago in 1964. Well, once again with no promotion or support, Dorsey went back to working at the auto shop along with gigging at various clubs requested by promoters. With Lee Dorsey returning back to his old habitat in the auto shop and gigging in nightclubs, what he's about to encounter is a new revived phase in his recording career and launch a new genre in R&B music.